So during the last COVID lockdown, I did a desktop tour of Rwanda. Now, everything's opened up again now, but it reminded me of a trip I took to Idjwi in 2018, and I thought I'd do another quick desktop tour of that. It's mostly going to be photos, because back then I wasn't really doing video footage, but I think very few tourists go to Idjwi, and so it's an interesting topic to cover. So Idjwi is a large island on Lake Kivu between Rwanda and DRC, and it actually belongs to DRC. It's got a population of about 250,000 people, and it's the second largest lake island in Africa after Ukerewe on Lake Victoria. So Idjwi's got a sort of a mythical status. Before visiting, the only thing that I'd heard about it is that in olden times, if a woman fell pregnant out of wedlock in Rwanda, then their family would load them onto a boat, row them out to Idjwi, and throw them overboard. And it was said that men from the island would rescue these women and take them home with them, so they sort of walk down to the shores and pick up a ready-made family. Now, how true this is, or how often it actually happened, I have no idea. But that's pretty much the main story anybody ever hears about Idjwi. So getting there isn't that cheap. If you're a tourist visiting DRC, you're likely to need a visa, which can cost around $120 to $150. However, if you're a resident in Rwanda, you can cross into the North and South Kivu region on a sepgel, which is a little piece of paper that you can pick up at Rwanda Immigration. It costs about $10 and it lasts for about 3 months as multiple entry. So carry it with you and get it stamped when you cross the border. If you're going further inland, then you will need a visa. But just for the border regions, a sepgel is fine. So I went in 2018 with my friend Maya and her daughter Taya. Now, there are very few people I go on really wacky adventures with, but she always manages to convince me. And the other nice thing is that Maya speaks fluent French. Now, I don't, and if you're going to travel into DRC, it's a very francophone country, and you either need to be able to speak French or go with somebody who does. So we started off by travelling from Kigali to Gisenyi, which is on the northern border with DRC. It's about a 3 to 3.5 hour bus ride from Kigali, and buses in Rwanda run really regularly from Nyabugogo Bus Park. It only costs about $5 to get there. Now, I've talked about Gisenyi in my desktop tour, so I won't go into any detail here, but we spent the evening relaxing by the infinity pool at Nirvana Hotel, which has a beautiful view of Lake Kivu. We stayed at a Catholic guest house near the border, and we were up at 5 a.m. the next morning to cross into Goma. Now, crossing into Goma is really easy, as there's now a swanky new customs building, but loads of people cross the border for work in the mornings, so you want to get there fairly early because it will be crowded. On the other side of the border, we took a taxi to the dock and boarded the Kivu Princess, which set sail at 7:30. Tickets at the time were about $50, and it's a good idea to book in advance because they sell out quickly. However, there was a cafe on the dock, so we did manage to get a cup of coffee and some sandwiches for breakfast. So Idjwi is split into north and south. We arrived at Bugarula Bay in the north and booked into Hopeland Hotel, which is right on the waterfront. I can't stress this enough. When visiting Idjwi, take cash. There are no ATMs on the island and no one accepts cards. So take enough to cover your expenses. You also need to be aware that both electricity and water come and go, so take a battery pack if you plan on using your phone much. Most places only have electricity at night when the generators come on, and you can order hot water to be delivered in a bucket for your morning wash. After a little rest, we decided to explore. We were told that the local market was 10 minutes away by moto, so we decided to walk. Now, ambling about is something that foreigners don't generally do in eastern DRC, for very good reasons, which I'll go into in another video. Suffice to say, it's not a safe zone and things can change very quickly. But the really nice thing about Idjwi is that it seems to have avoided the conflict of the mainland. We felt really safe walking around and locals were really happy to greet us and give us directions. When I asked about safety on the island, one man laughed and explained, "Idjwi is very safe. Here we have a king, but no politicians." Our decision to walk was perhaps a little foolhardy because we were still going about 3 hours later. But eventually we found the market and it was epic. There were so many people there selling everything from sugarcane to indigara. We found a little bar and sat down for a well-earned beer. Having learnt our lesson, we took motos back to the hotel and nibbled on sugarcane, pineapple and amandazi, whilst the chef prepared the yams and indigara we'd bought from the market. The hotel had two adorable puppies, which completely stole our hearts. And the meal was ready just in time for a lovely view of the sunset. The next day, we decided to hop on motos down to the south of the island. Another top tip, pack light. We didn't, and I can tell you from experience that hefting a large suitcase on an off-road motorbike trip is not an experience you want to repeat. Also, wear sunscreen. Now, it takes about 2 hours to get from the north of the island to the south, and it's something you can only do during the dry season. During the wet, the roads turn to mud and parts of it become impassable. Not to mention, you don't really want to be sitting on a motorbike for 2 hours in the rain. That said, it's a really amazing trip. Everybody we met was so friendly, and there's a shipwreck halfway down the island that marks the border between North and South Idjwi. Our moto driver did tell us the history of the ship, but I'm afraid I've forgotten. So if anyone knows, please do drop it in the comments. When we reached the south of the island, we checked into Kongomani Guest House. As with anywhere in the region, food takes time to prepare, so order before you get too hungry and take snacks with you. Even hotels have to send out to the market for supplies. But we ate really well at Kongomani, with a spread of pineapple, avocado, omelette, oranges, rice and potatoes. We had only really planned to visit Idjwi, but Mai had a friend working at Luiro Chimpanzee Sanctuary, based at the Institut Congolais de Conservation de Nature on the mainland. So we joined a passenger boat and headed that way. Halfway to Katana, our boat hit a fuel line problem, and we spent about 20 minutes drifting around in circles whilst the captain sucked air out of the pipeline. Definitely one of my most vivid memories of the trip. But we made it safe and sound and took a tour of both the Institute and the Chimpanzee Sanctuary. This is me entire staring at tadpoles in the pond. And here we are with the apes, wearing masks long before they were fashionable. This is to protect the apes from contracting human viruses. Sadly, I didn't take many pictures of the sanctuary, but the chimps were fairly terrifying. I was expecting PG tips chimps like the ones in this picture, but some were over a metre tall and built out of solid muscle. Definitely wouldn't want to get too close to one. Then we had a decision to make, whether to take another boat back to Idjwi and catch the ferry back to Goma, or whether to continue south to Bukavu. Now neither Maya or myself had ever been to Bukavu before, but to get there, we would have to take a taxi through the notorious South Kivu region, which is definitely not a safe place, with frequent rebel attacks and kidnappings. After discussing with friends and guides, we decided to make the journey, and having made it, I would strongly urge others not to. Nothing happened to us, but there was definitely an air of unease, and so we didn't really relax and enjoy the journey. You're very isolated if something does happen in that region, so it's a much safer idea to take the ferry from Idjwi to Bukavu instead. Mainland DRC and North and South Kivu are not places you want to be wandering around as a tourist. Also, the roads in DRC are serious. Drivers fall into potholes and wake up in parallel dimensions, and even short distances can take a really long time to cover. When we finally made it to Bukavu, we checked into Kivu Best Hotel and found a nice little resto called Lacacia, with a great view of the lake. Accommodation in Bukavu isn't particularly cheap, and even when the plague isn't happening, there's usually a curfew, as with Goma. But I do like Bukavu. The houses have pretty carved wooden windows and are often painted bright colours. We felt safe there and the people were friendly. I've been a couple of times since and I prefer it to Goma. It feels more relaxed. It was definitely nice to be able to take a hot shower and charge our phones. So the next morning we walked across the border to Changugu in the south of Rwanda and took the bus back to Kigali. The tickets are cheap, about $7, but it's not for the faint-hearted. The road from Changugu to Hue is extremely windy in places, and it's not uncommon for people to throw up. I once had an infant throw up all over me, and I had to sit like that for 4 hours. So, top tip, put your bag on your lap or your seat. Don't leave it on the floor. We made it back to Kigali by late evening. We were absolutely exhausted, but pretty chuffed with ourselves that we'd made it. I would definitely recommend Idjwi as an experience. As I said, the people were really friendly and we felt safe walking around. We even met the local police chief who welcomed us and told us a bit about the island. But also be prepared. It isn't a luxury destination. It's a cash economy, there aren't any banks, and often no electricity or running water. So be prepared for that. But we really enjoyed ourselves. As mentioned though, if you do plan to visit Lueru, I wouldn't recommend hanging around on the mainland. For safety's sake, it's better to return to Idjwi and take the passenger ferry either to Goma or Bukavu. You get a real sense of security on Idjwi that doesn't translate to the mainland. But if you want to step into eastern DRC, then this is definitely the best place to go.